Namaskar. I am Professor Bharat Gupt here at Indira Gandhi National Center for the Arts. It is my great fortune that I am in conversation with one of the leading Tamil experts and Sanskrit scholar of our country, Dr. Ramachandra Nagaswamy. He is an eminent epigraphist. He was the Director General of the Southern Region of Archaeological Survey of the India. He is one of the most famous scholars of iconography. So, dear friends, we are going to talk about today a very important subject, and that is the classic called Silapadigaram. Now, this is one of the most famous texts of ancient India, and Professor Nagaswamy, you are most welcome, sir, to give us this opportunity. And I'd like to ask you a question, a specific question. Very often it is said, sir, that Silapadigaram represents a tradition from the south of India, which is independent of any northern influences or of northern connections. Now, how far that is true, sir? Is this great poem or kavyam or a book of theatrical activity and performance, is it related to a similar tradition in the north, specifically the tradition of the Natya Shastra? What is your take, sir?
Now, the concept of Silapadigaram is generally so far thought to be an epic in Tamil. And some people thought it is almost a historical narration of Kannaki, the heroine of this poem. And they consider that it reflects the pure Tamil tradition, totally independent from Sanskrit tradition. This is a view of some scholars, some politicians. And but the poem is so beautiful, outstanding, that you feel like saying that it is mine, is exclusively mine. It's not so. It's not independent of the pan-Indian culture. It's in the total tradition of Bharata's Natya Shastra.
You mean Silapadigaram is a Nataka Kavyam in the tradition of Bharat Muni?
Yeah, it is not my view. I follow the view of a medieval commentator, Adiyark Nallar, who has given an excellent commentary on Silapadigaram in total, and who says that this is a Nataka Kavya.
This was said as early as 13th century, did you say?
Around 13th century. There is an early commentary also. That doesn't give a word-to-word translation or commentary. But Adiyark Nallar, he works on the earlier commentary and enlarges it with outstanding knowledge of music and dance. And so he justifies why he calls it Nataka Kavya. We need not go into the details of all that. It's very evident from the very beginning that it is a composition, and perhaps the earliest composition in a regional language following the tradition of Natya Shastra in India. So this is the earliest regional language Natya Kavya, Nataka Kavya. available today because it can be assigned to 2nd century AD. The simple points about this text is that it is in three parts, three cantos. One is located in the Chola country called Pumpuhar, so it is called Puhar Kandam. The second part of the incident located in Madurai, that is the capital of the Pandya ruler. And the third part is located in the Chera kingdom, Vanji. So the event relating to these episodes are all located in three kingdoms. The kings who were the leaders at that point of time is, according to the first kanda, is Karigala, the first part, Pandyan Nedunjeriyan in the second part, and the most famous ruler of the Chera king is Cheran Senguttuvan in the third part. We know from the Sanskrit tradition, when dramas are enacted, in ancient times both dance and drama were one.
They were together.
We call Natakam. So in the Natakam, we generally see that at the beginning, where the dance is enacted, the king in whose court that dance was enacted, he is mentioned for the first time. And also you will see his name at the very end of the composition. In this Silapadikaram, though the first part is located in the Chola country, it begins with the Chera Senguttuvan, whose brother Ilango Adigal composed this Natyakavya. So the event takes place in the king Chera, who is the hero at the very end of the drama also. It ends with, begins with Chera Senguttuvan and ends with Chera Senguttuvan, which is in the Sanskrit tradition. Now, there are what is called Pāyiram. Pāyiram is the first verse, introductory verse. And Katturai is Prabandha, Bandha, Prabandha. At the end of each and every kanda, there is a Katturai. Katturai is a Bandha. That shows on what basis the first part has been composed by the poet himself. The poet himself says, I have composed this first part, this is my main point which around which I take the whole story. There he uses the word Bharati Vritti. I have used Bharati Vritti for the first kanda.
So he makes a generalization,
yes,
about the first kanda,
yes,
saying that
the underlying principle that
of Bharati Vritti will be
dance
employed.
Tradition that has been used,
right,
is Bharati Vritti. In the second one, he says that he uses Arabhati and Satvati Vrittis, two Vrittis. We know from Bharata's Natya Shastra, there are four Vrittis.
Right, sir.
Arabhati, Satvati, Bharati,
and Kaisiki.
Kaisiki Vritti.
Right.
In this one, he has not used Kaisiki Vritti, though in the first part, we have a dancing girl who is introduced, and the whole aspect of Natya Shastra's tradition, which it is specifically mentioned as Natya Nannul. The dancer who is introduced is said to be a master of Natya Nannul, that is Natya Shastra.
Madhavi.
Madhavi is said to master that, and the performances are based on that. You know, the whole chapter is on Natya Shastra tradition, the composer, the musician, the Vaidyakara, all these are all mentioned in this one. So, the first part is heavily dependent upon the Natya Shastra tradition. The second one, where the unfortunate hero is killed,
right,
and there is a lot of bhatas, they come into
action,
what you call play, and that reflects the Arabhati tradition.
Vritti, because there is so much conflict Arabhati and sorrow and fighting.
Then it leads on to a quietude at the later period, so Satvati is introduced.
Right.
The third part, which is called the Vanjikandam, it is in Puram tradition. The first two are in Aham tradition, which centered around the Sringara Bhava, because
that is the Aham tradition.
A married hero, Kovalan, marries Kannagi, a chaste woman. And though he married her, he went after a dancing girl. And so that goes in the Aham tradition of Sringara. Actually, if you see, there is no need for Madhavi at all in the tradition, running tradition, except to emphasize that this is in the dance tradition, dramatic tradition, Nataka tradition. And in the third part, there is a Katturai. That Katturai, that is the end poem. That one is called Nool Katturai. That is Katturai for the entire composition.
Not just the third part.
Whole text. So there the poet, Ilango Vadigal, says what he has written. He says, from Kumari to Vengadam, in the land called Tamilagam, where both Sen Tamil and Kodun Tamil, this classical and spoken Tamil is in use. I am composing this by using Aham and Puram tradition, and then I use Sol, Purul, and Yajithi Sol Purul. That is script, Yajithi, Sol is the Pada, and Purul is the Artha. So with the help of Yajithi Sol and Purul,
I provide the Artha.
I am composing poetry, flawless poetry. Yapu, that is classical poem. And this classical poem, I am converting it into music with Pan, Yayal, and Pani. Pan is poetry, Yayal means how you set it to beginning, you know, Vardhani Raga, and then Pani is
different tala, stages of tala.
So, with the help of Yajithi Sol Purul, he has composed Aham and Puram, and then Seyyul. Seyyul is the classical poem, and this poem is now set to music. And then he says, this music I am converting into Ranga and Vilak and Kutu.
So he makes it very clear that this is to be performed on stage.
And then he says, with this I am reflecting the life of the people, Tamil people, as if I am reflecting in a mirror the great hill as a reflection. So through the media of dance, drama, arangu, kutu, I am reflecting the culture of the people of the Tamil country. So, whatever was there in the life of the people, he is projecting it in the tradition of drama.
So he also echoes the dictum of Natya Shastra that Natak or Natya is a Lokanukriti, that it reflects the life of the people.
Yes.
Right.
But remember, this Arabhati Vritti, this Bharati Vritti, and Satvati Vritti is exactly what is defined in Bharata's Natya.
Yes, these are very specific technical terms. On the and the vrittis are very fundamental to the production of rupakas.
Yes.
You know, because it is the vrittis which compose the rupakas.
Yes.
So, without vritti, there can be no rupaka, and it is the combination of vritti which makes a rupaka.
Yeah. So this is there could be no doubt that I think, and the medieval commentator felt it. Because he was a master of both music and dance, he has given very great detailed description of then prevalent music and dance and the shastras and so on. He calls it Nataka Kavya, and without understanding what is what you call Bharati Vritti, what is Satvati Vritti, what is Arabhati Vritti, you cannot understand what is the underlying principle of this dance song. So there could be no doubt that it is a dance song.
And that it is a continuation of the tradition of Natya Shastra.
Yes.
Because vrittis are made fundamental here.
Yes.
You know. And yatha tatha vritti bhedai natya rupa bhavanti hi. This is what the Natya Shastra says.
And there are more informations also about the role of Agastya and the Urvasi coming down from heaven to earth, and Narada Veena being played, and this Jayanta story, which are all from Natya Shastra, which is embedded into the story of
Silpadigaram.
Yes. Unless one understands Natya Shastra, there is another point. You have here a chaste woman, Kannaki, and this is the glorification of chastity of women, Pattini. She is called Veerapattini. So, this Karpu, we call it Karpu, what is the Kalpita, is the main theme of glorification here, which is again in
of
the
Dampatya
tradition.
Yes, it is the Dampatya Dharma Shastra tradition.
Yes, we know 8 kinds of dances are there. And the first kind is Brahma type of Vivaha,
right,
where
sir.
Kalpu is the Kalpita is the main one for the women, and that is the source of both what you call Dharma Shastra,
exactly,
and Natya Shastra. Here there's another point. This Kannaki is referred to in one of the ancient Sangam poems, in a different context. The great patron who had Kannagi, his wife, he left her young wife and he went after a dancing girl. And 4 or 5 great poets, Tamil poets, says, what are you doing? When you have such a lovely wife waiting for you at home, you go after public girls, return back and see that she is comforted. So 4 or 5 great poets have sung and indicted that fellow going after public girl. There, the heroine's name is given as Kannaki. So a known historical name has been adopted, and a creative, imaginative hero is created, which is one of the forms which is mentioned in Natya Shastra.
Exactly.
existing person and a creative imaginary person.
Again, from Lokadharmi, it transformed into Natyadharmi.
This is how. Kannagi's story is almost the same. And there are many other evidences in between where we have references to Panchatantra stories.
I see.
The whole Panchatantra story is mentioned in the middle. And then there are the mantra, Devi mantra, that is mentioned in the Shakti mantra, is mentioned.
Worship of the Devi, you mean?
Worship of the Devi. No, the mantra will carry them through the forest.
Yes.
Yes, so this is a very, very well-known Sanskrit tradition. That is
it
there.
Is, mantra is like a kavacha.
Yes. So, then at the very beginning, this is most important. The first, at the very beginning, we get Indra festival. Indra festival is always there in the Natya Shastra.
Yes, that
at the
is
very
how,
beginning.
That is how the first performance is done.
Indra Vida, it is said.
I see.
And the whole process of worship there is Shiva worship, Vishnu worship, and Subramanya worship, Indra, Varuna. Mm. All these gods are all worshipped at the very beginning stage itself. So there is no way of separating it. And at no point of time in history there was any iron curtain between north and south. It was always one, and
there was great interchange.
Intermingling.
Always. Right, sir.
And so the idea.
And people were always recreating in different regions some very fundamental all India concepts.
Yeah.
Which had been generated over generations of the Shastric tradition.
It's one more point that requires, in the composition of poetry, Natya Shastra mentions one form of composition called Yamaka.
You're right.
Yamaka, he gives different kinds of Yamaka. Yamaka means repetition of words.
Yes.
Or it may be even half a pada, or full sentence, it
repeated.
Repeated. And this repetition is meant specially for dance purposes, because the bhava can be communicated by repeatedly mentioning this same pada or same emotion. So we have beautiful places where in Sangam literature itself, we have this Yamaka used, which again shows that it has imbibed traditions of Natya Shastra. But in Chilapadikaram, it is used so beautifully, wonderfully. Nadandai Vadi Kaveri. It's a beautiful description of river Kaveri flowing in a beautiful manner. It is repeated. Again and again. It is what is called the Yamaka part, the sentence, whole part of the sentence. Kaanada kannenna kanne, kannimaitthu kaanbaardhan kannenna kanne. It's the same word is repeated, which emphasizes so beautifully, and that Yamaka has been handled by Ilangovodigal in a masterly manner.
So he was, Ilangovodigal is not only imbibing fundamental concepts but also the alankaras.
Alankaras.
And the employment of those alankaras.
Yeah. It's a beautiful one. It will move you. It's the highest form of poetry. Then in Nataka we have separate poems for dance and also Gadya and Padya, both are used.
Right.
And so here also we
it
have
is used.
Urai, Katurai, both Padya and Gadya. So we have many points that converge to show that it is one in character.
Yes, there was constant interchange and one great vision and one great employment of that vision in north as well as in south. Sir, I am very thankful to you for making this very specific enunciation, and by giving it a solid basis from textual evidence. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
So, dear audience, we had this most enlightened interview from Professor R. Nagaswamy, and I am sure that you enjoyed it greatly. Namaskar.